Hello, ClampK here, and welcome back to Streaming Warhammer Miniatures. We are going to start after figuring out what pieces we can use. That would be this one and this one. We're gonna start. Oops, that's actually gonna come closer. That can go there. Tess can go here. I think I should say it again just because it's how we're going. We are going to start by adding some paint to our palette. It's going to be our nice brown color. Add in some matte. We'll need that again. This drink can come over here. A good stir. Now, what we are going to start with is continuing working on the warrior. So, we're going to get the bottom of the legs, the upper part here. And then I think we will start on his torso, which is set aside in this little baggie to indicate that he is a prime. So let's go ahead, grab our brushes, slide them up. Now what I'm curious on, and I think I looked at this and determined that no, I probably shouldn't. Oops. Helps if I got it going into the right side. So can I paint that? Well, that's not right. That's not right. Which way do you go in? You go there, you come here. So you go in like that. You could. I don't really want to. So we won't. So, as we said, got a couple areas to start on. Start on his torso, because it's the least issue we got. Make sure I am in focus over here, and not the tiger in the background. Can we zoom? Ooh, we can zoom in. So let's go ahead and do that. Make sure we are in focus. Here we go. All right, so as I was saying, I'm gonna go ahead and start painting in up here. Just getting that base coat down. Soften you up a little. So you let this stuff fly more freely. Yeah, that's better. No, we're probably going to be sanding off some of this, but we just want to get it covering everything here for the first round. We I'm gonna pop those bubbles as well. Let's stick this little toothpick here. That might do it. It'll probably be better once we start adding it onto this guy here. Or this leg here. Because it's probably some of that water that we put on the brush. So actually, is that water we put on the brush? What's that? There we go. You can dry. Come on. Thank you. Leg number two, or number one. Again, not because it's actually going to be this color, but to make sure that the paint seals around the edge. Let's do that. That looks like it's covering everything for now. So we come up here onto the torso. That in like so. Make sure we come in there. We're covering all this just to make sure every part gets covered. All right, So he can stand on his back, which means that we can get all of this painted. That's that, which means we're now on to his neck. Probably should have shaved that off. Oops. Oh well. That's not going to be a big deal if I don't get it. Until I go and put his head on. Just to make sure we get all of it on this side. I'm gonna cut up like that. Let him rest over there. Let him rest way up there so he's out of the range of us being able to hit him. So with that all drying, we're gonna get the front portion, these termagant legs. There, we'll probably move on to working on those spine fists again. Actually, two of them with one layer, or two of them with two layers and one with two with one layer. So we'll work on finishing up the second layer on the ones that we didn't do. I am wondering what I'm touching, because I've apparently been touching it quite a bit. Okay. Four. Alright, so start down here, work our way up. Good news is on most of the head. That seems like a bubble that's going to need popping. A couple of those do actually. Make sure we get here on that neck. Somewhere about right there. Need a little bit more love. Wait. Yep. This one. So that was not a bubble, so we're good. Oh, I might have screwed something up. Let's take another look at this. Yeah, I screwed something up. It looked weird to me. Painted that on. Now let's spread it around. That's been spread around, so we can come back here. Just make sure that that is not too heavy. You can go dry up there. Coming along. That was odd. That's looking pretty good. Let's get around the back side of the head. go. That's the front of the tail. Well, it's looking pretty good as well. Alright, so those are set to dry, so onto spine fists. To follow as well as I can my original plan, doing one segment at a time. So right now we're working on the main arm. Here. So when we go back to that, in just a minute, here we go. We can actually pick up the paint that we really heavily painted on. Make it happy again. tree. Probably need to ditch a little bit of this as well. Thank you, little scrap piece. You're now out of the way. Out over there as well. Which leaves us with the last of these arms. Looks pretty good. Alright, arms are done, legs are done, they're drying, bodies are done. And I think in that case we move on to red. It's either that or start some of the other warriors, but I kinda wanna get this guy at least partially put together before we get that far. So, red. We need a drop of regular red. That's orange. This is red. I know you're in there. Thank you. Let's drop red. That is about a drop of brown. A little bit worried in the middle there because I thought we had a bubble. We did not. 2 drops of mat to mix it all up. Thank you. That should be mixed well enough now. So we'll start over here. Add a pinch of water to this guy. Start on its legs. Let's trim up these leg plates.
Demanding or too greedy, your mind is not rich and self-sufficient. When your mind becomes demanding, when you long for something, you will end up violating your own precepts, not to tell lies, not to steal, not to kill, not to be immoral, and so forth. If you keep your original mind, precepts will keep themselves. Beginner's mind is the mind of compassion. When our mind is compassionate, it is boundless.
And this last little plate over here. Sorry about that. If we come in this way. So I kind of screwed up on the first 8 of them by gluing the body parts together. Because it makes it a pain in the butt to get in on that inner spot. So, we're not going to do that on those other 4. And we've already started not doing that on some of them. this guy. I gotta get in around here. And that's that one. Right? Well, almost. Stitch some of that up there. Some more down there. A little bit overboard. So that gets that. Now we have to get back around this side. Yep, right there. How best to get there? Think. That is not it. This might be it. For most of it, at least. Come back this way. Come in this way, maybe? Yeah, this way. We take just what we need. Right there. And then coming back down this way. Be a little bit less concerned with how pretty it looks and get in there. So now we're after the rest of his carapace. So that looks like the first coat on that half. Which means we now get to be careful and get in between his neck and his carapace here. So we'll start by painting on some here. Or actually finish up painting on right here. Now that we've done that, this should be light enough that we can get in there. Alright, so that looks pretty good. We'll take a little more paint. Come in this way. Gonna come in on the bottom. think that gets most of that. So back up here to the skull cap. Then right here at the very tip. Back here. That one looks pretty good. So you can chill out right there. Back to this one. That way, cut out there. You know, I probably should have put you more over this way. So as I work over here, you can see what I'm actually doing. Toothpick you can stick off to the side. Alright, that cut most of that one. This one we can come in this way. Pick up just a little bit more. In there. Go. That part's done. Which means we can go ahead and paint in here. Dropping him. Because that was what we wanted to do. Okay. So, coming in this side now. that's not too thick right there. We gotta come in this side. Check, check. Check, which means to see what we are doing, we need to go this way. On to right here. Which means his lawyer is done. So now we're going to trim up the rest of him. Start right here, on our way back. So the brush is starting to get a little bit of stick to it. So we'll see how far we can get. Imagine his skull, because most of the rest of it looks pretty good. There's a little bit right there. And then there's that guy. So those two have been done. We're gonna go ahead and open up this fizzy drink. Dry off our hands. Now, I think I do want to try something. It's a prime, so it's alright if he looks unique. We are going to take one on purple through it. Or we want to do it on his shell. No, we'll run some green. Green. Thank you, come on. Come on. Okay, you're open. Let's try you now. Will you come out? Thank you. So what I want to try, come on, thank you, it's taking a little bit of sponge, tearing at it some. Let's go and dip that in there just to clean it off. Then we gotta dry it out. Alright, that should be pretty good there. So you can go back up there, pull out our mat. And our mixing stick. Go mixing this up all nice. Now I'm not sure if this is gonna work the way I wanted to, but I may have been watching someone else do some stuff. She's actually doing like the full body makeup tutorials, which are kind of neat to watch anyways. Because she'll do things like turn herself into Jack Skellington, or the Stitch It Up lady there. And one of the things she was doing was she was doing a zombie look. So she took and tore up the sponge like this. So we're just going to dip a little bit in there. I'll dip it in there. Now what we're going to try to do is put on a undercoat here. Let's see how this works, because we're only putting an additional layer. That's not what I wanted. We went way too heavy there. Way, way, way too heavy. But that's good to know. Gotta go and once you get some of that on there, take a lot of it off. Either that or we want a lot more stuff on this. See, that actually makes it look more the way I wanted. So it's gonna be a lot thinner, is what it comes down to. Because when it's super thin, some of it actually stays on the sponge. It's only partially imprinted there. Let's take a little bit more. let's try it over here on the legs this time around. Yep, that's what I want. Just to give him some highlights in the thing. It's also possible that I needed a lot thinner, a lot smaller sponge. I wouldn't doubt that a bit. But we'll see how that works out. But now we're gonna go wash our hands because it's all it. And that's gonna get all over everything. So we'll be right back. So we are back. We have gotten most of that paint off. Let's just get rid of that there. Well, we'll see how a green undertone looks on him there. I forgot something though. That would be, I gotta get his chest too. Okay. So we're wobbling everything. But. Come on. You're just up on his back. A little bit ago. There we go. I think that means we can put the second coat on the arm. Let's take our brush, clean it up, get all that water off. Need a little bit more of the brown because we used up a lot of it earlier. Thank you. should be dry enough over here, but we just want to make sure. So we should be mixed up pretty good there. So we'll start with these two segments. That can free up some paint from there. Now we gotta come in from here. We can do this section first. Just a raised up section. Nope, you're not. I was just going at you the wrong way. Now, I didn't go back to the spine fists first, because I know I want to put the red on here tonight. I'd really like to get the orange on here tonight as well, but I don't know if we're gonna get that far. So we'll settle for what we get. That looks like that's that part. Alright, so those are all set. Do we risk touching the spine fists? I think so. Spine fists are good to go. I should be going down this way as well. Yeah. Tune. Tree. Could I really do that? Okay. So that one looks solid. Or at least appears solid. So these ones are solid. Good to know. we go. So that's that. You need red. You still need another coat of brown. I think we might be able to do it. So let's go ahead and do it. And see how this looks up. Alright, so there is definitely some merit in this idea. I just don't think the implementation was right. We did that side, we want this side. Thank you. You can rest yourself out. Let's do the smart like, unlike that side. We'll do the top. so there definitely is some tinging there, which is what we wanted. We wanted a less solid tinge, though. More of a pattern look beneath them. That's why I can't find any holes down there. No matter how hard I look, there are none. There, on the other hand, I know there are holes. Like that, and we go like that. I think that about covers you. There we go. Let the brown sit itself out for a bit. Take another sip of this. Back to red. Start on you. Yes. Yes. Alright. Looks like one coat was added to these guys. So we'll start with one coat here. Hair go away. I know you balance. Thank you. So this is all supposed to be red. So we're gonna go make that red now. So don't get a fight with it later. I think it ends right there. So we gotta be really careful on this one. The head is a lot lower than some of the other ones. That does it. Might be a little bit too heavy here, so let's convince as much of it as we can to get out of the way. Go. Wait. Where'd you go? It was you. It's either you. Yeah, it's you. Yep, we forgot there. There we go. Now you're done. For now. That oh.